From MPs to ministers and supporters, the Barbados Labour Party's suggestions were documented. The BLP again signaled its support for the qualifying age for MPs to be moved to 18, a point reiterated by Minister of People Empowerment and Elder Affairs Kirk Humphrey. Another recommendation, this time from MP for St. Michael's South Central Marsha Callow, was for Barbados to look into campaign finance reform.
We have had several conversations about the question of the Auditor General. We have had several conversations about members of Parliament and therefore members of Cabinet being able to operate with a certain level of independence in the affairs of the state. We consider that for true independence to take place in that regard, that there has to be some separation of the fundraising or of the way that elections are fundraised for and financed. That means that members of Parliament, in keeping perhaps with a new code of ethics to which they swear, would not then depend on private interests solely in order to finance election campaigns.
The BLP also recommended political parties be recognized in the Constitution and registered. Furthermore, people's assemblies were touted as a local governance model. The session at BLP headquarters marked the close of public sessions of the Parliamentary Reform Commission. Chairman Sir Richard Cheltenham said the commission still has a lot of work to do,
including devising a code of ethics for parliamentarians and revisiting the terms and conditions under which parliamentarians serve. These are among some of the responsibilities which we still have going forward. I want to thank the public too for their positive and supportive response. The work of the Commission would not have been possible without it.
The Commission is still open to receiving and considering written submissions from the public. A report is expected to be submitted to the President by mid-February 2024. Kishmar St, CBC News.